Hello, this is Howie, and in this episode of Exposed by Math, does car payments of $550 a month really equal $1 million in lost opportunity? If you want to know, stay tuned. I'll go over some numbers and facts, and I'll try to model it out using a spreadsheet to see what you think. So stick around and see this episode. But before we do, I want to do one quick announcement. Before we begin this week's episode, please like and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I normally do different topics and I put them in different playlists, and you can see that here. You pick the topics you like. I do a generic money topic. If you like these Exposed by Math, you do it here. I do trading. These are my trading ones. I create one new for each quarter. I have dividend ones, I have product reviews, Bible ones. So you pick and choose which one you like to see. And keep an eye on things like this. There's cash giveaway that I do. I did one for Black Friday. I have another one for Xmas cash. So keep an eye for those things. So let's go back to the video. So let's try to answer this. Can car payments really make you broke? So before we go on, let's hear about some of these rules of thumbs that we heard. You can afford about half your salary for a car. Keep your car payments to about 10% of your monthly payment. It costs more to repair an old car than to get a new one. My car is nearly 100,000 miles. Time to trade in or sell it now while it's under 100, because some people believe after 100, it just costs too much to repair or the car will break. Or some people still believe leasing is still cheaper. So let's talk about some of these rules of thumb. And here you go. Here's one of them. Finance a car no more than 4 years. That makes sense. Look at this one here. Keep your car payments 10% of your gross. That's where we got that one from. Here's another one. How much do you spend on a car? And you see, this one is very popular. I heard this one for the last 20 years, which is saying if you make 60, you can drive around in a $30,000 car, okay? And this saying has been around a long time. I heard this in the 1990s. So this is not something new. And then the rest of them you probably heard before too. So with that being said, this is the current statistics of cars. 550 is probably the average for a new car. 381 is for a used car. I believe the data is from 2019. Oh, here goes an updated one. This one says 330, 381. Let's just see real quick what it says. Monthly payment, amount, loan, length. And you see this. Here's a typical average loan payment. 5%, uses 9. Here's the length. So there's some interesting things about this. And the average household income is about $68,000 in America today. And if you apply some of the rules, here's some things. They keep it under 10%. The average loan is roughly 6 years nowadays. When I started out, it was about 48 months was normal. Then it went to 60. Today, you'll see 72 months, 84 months, and sometimes even longer. So what does that mean? If you look at some of the math, there's some interest here. But there's more. There's more to this before we start doing the math. If you get a new car, here's your loan. If you have a used car or paid off car, you got zero payments. Some people still have to, if you follow some type of planning for the future, you save money every month so you can buy a car. But there's a cost to it. Full coverage for auto insurance could be expensive on a newer car. I don't know what it is. Every state is slightly different. But I just said, okay, let's use a number like 75. You're still going to need, you don't have to have full coverage on a paid off car, but auto insurance still costs something. So there is a cost, but it's cheaper. Car washes. Most of the time when you have a new car, it makes sense to wash your car multiple times a month. You don't want to damage the paint. On an older car, if it's fading, the paint is no longer glossy. Most of us will just get the garden hose and I don't want to say you throw rocks at it, but my point is you don't have to take as good care of your old car. So your car wash cost is cheaper. There's some other stuff. Maintenance may still be there. You still have to allocate oil changes, buy new tires every couple of years. Sure, the maintenance on a used car or an older car is higher. Gas is, depending on the argument. If you bought a fuel efficient car, then yes, you can save money on gas. If you bought yourself a minivan because your family is growing, you're probably going to get less gas mileage. Or if you get good gas mileage, you're paying for it through the cost of the car. Whereas your old car, while maybe smaller, you may get less gas performance. In certain cities, some people don't choose cars because you can Uber around everywhere. So you do save money if you can Uber, but some people Uber $400, $500, $600, $700 a month. COVID has probably reduced some of the Uber costs. People can't go out, restaurants are closed, clubs are closed, movie theaters and all these other stuff, vacationing. So your Uber spending has gone down. So let's go into some of the math now. Now what we're gonna do is let's plug in the value of a new car. If you were spending 550 with 0%, this is how much money you're spending on a car. Oh, I did something wrong. It's 550 per month, so you need to multiply that by 12, and you see it's 6,600. So here's a better number. So if I'm 50 years old and I'm spending about average 550 a month, here's how much money I'm spending on new cars in the next 15 years, $100,000. And I'm using 0% interest because I'm not factoring in anything, just how much money am I spending, okay? So that's the first baseline. If you want to see this, if you are younger, if you're 40 years old, you can see this. If you're buying new cars for the next 25 years, $165,000. In order for us to determine what the opportunity cost is, you have to assume that you can put that money and invest it in something like the stock market or real estate. We will use, for right now, let's start off with a 7% interest rate. If you're spending an average, making 7%, this is what it will mean. You can see how investing $550 a month, instead of buying a new car early in your life or throughout your life, you can see the opportunity cost does hit over $1 million. And that's using 7%. Let's go back up here. Let's replace it with something more reasonable. The stock market has returned 10% a year. If you do this, you can see where the million-dollar mark is much quicker. 29 years into this model, I can predict that you will have $1 million by the time you're 53 if you started this right after college. And this is just one aspect. This is just saying reduce your car payments. So going back here, if you're making the average, we can see that the average 10% is generally, this is pretty close to it. You see that? This number is close to the 10% of this number because we looked at it. 550, you multiply by 12 months, it brings you to 6,600, which means you're making $66,000 a year. So the numbers are kind of interesting. The average household is already, or the average person in America is already spending close to 10%. So they are staying under this rule. The challenge is, depending on the cost of car, there's other things you need to factor in. Your $25,000 car is costing you way more than $25,000. We saw that there's other costs to it, but even an interest charge, there's a cost to it. So let me show you that. Here's a quick loan calculator. So let's use an average of like a $25,000 car. This calculator defaults it to a really low rate, and you can see the interest payment. Not bad. Over whatever amount of term, here it goes 5 years, you're paying $2,300. But let's say you're 5% interest rate, 60-month term. Now, most people are not doing 60 months, they're doing 72. So look at the cost already. A $25,000 car, 5%, 72 months, $4,000 in interest. What if you bought a car that's a little bit more expensive? We're gonna see that real quick. We're gonna punch in something more typical, like a $50,000 car that some people drive around in. You can see now the interest rate is, so this is embedded in your loan. This is pretty expensive, just an interest. So what do you do if you're in this situation? You have a choice. Instead of spending $550 a month on a new car, is there a way for you to keep it at zero? Well, the first answer is yes. If you already have a car, you can just pay it off and drive it until the wheels fall off. I know I have two used cars. Both of them are paid off. They're both about 10 years old. They run fine. They don't create black smoke or white smoke from the motor. You can go down the road and cops not going to pull you over. The cars are safe and they're reliable. And most of my cars always get over 100,000 miles. In fact, most of them get over 200,000 miles. I had a car 20 years ago. My first new car, I did buy a new car. My monthly payment was over $500 in the 1990s. But I paid it off in 2.5 years, I believe. So I had a $500 monthly payment on a car that was only worth $14,000. And I don't remember exactly how many months I paid it off in, but it was pretty quick. Now, I also got paid to drive the client sites due to the nature of my work. So I'm able to drive a new car, pay it off, didn't incur a lot of interest. My company paid for most of my commuting costs to the client site. I got paid mileage for it. So was it worth it? Absolutely. I remember doing the math and I got paid roughly $9,000 or $10,000 just to drive to the client site. So my car was almost given to me. But that doesn't change my habits. What I try to do is this. If I can keep this cost low, so what I did was once I paid off the car, I drove it for many, many years until I can replace it with another car that has a lower cost to it or a cheaper cost. And what I'm saying is if you have a newer car, pay it off and drive it for 10, 15 years. That will work. Now, if you cannot afford your car, most people say, well, just sell it, even if you take a loss on it, and then you drive around in something reliable but much cheaper and used, and you get into a habit of driving more modest cars that are safe, but not flashy. My car may not have a glossy paint anymore, or is a little bit more scratched up than normal, and that's okay. I'm not here to impress you with my car. So if you're able to do that by saving $500 on cars, and if you can do that for over extended period of time, let's just say 10, 15, or 20 years of your life, this should add up to quite a bit of money. This can be worth $500,000 added to your net worth. And that's just one component of this. Remember, we're saying instead of spending 10% of your household income in a car, if you can reduce this to lower than 5% or 4% or 2% or whatever it may be, then you can squeeze out money from this bucket of your budget that increases your net worth. The other thing is this. Out of your household budget, you should already be saving 10%. And what I mean by that is if 10% of your $68,000 household is being saved for the future and 10% is going to your car, what I'm saying is if you reduce your car expense to about 5% of your budget, that means you can increase the amount that you invest. And hopefully you understand what that means. So what I'm saying is if you're saving 10% and if your car is 10%, what I'm saying is spend 5 on your car, increase your investment for the future to 15%. So what that would look like is 68,000, if I can just type this in correctly, $68,000 times the 15%, right? And there you go. That would mean now you're able to save about $10,000 per year. And if you're able to do this, even at the age of 30 years old, you can see how becoming a millionaire takes 25 years. And that's just doing two things. following a simple 10% rule, save 10% of everything you make, plus reducing your car payments or your car expense from 10 to 5%, and this is how you get to the 15% mark, and this is how you hit it. And this is the reason why we want you to say, so this is true. Your car payment is making you broke. The amount of money you are spending on your car is just one component to it. If you just change this one area, you can see how this is worth $500,000 to $1 million. The math shows this is true. Car payments are draining you of lots of lost opportunity. Instead of you pulling up to a light in a nice shiny Mercedes, Benz, or BMW, you can be driving off in a paid off car, and you can have $1 million just in this one behavior change. If you do other stuff, it is not very hard for you to hit $2 or $3 or $4 million. So hopefully you enjoyed this episode. The math shows it. If you invest some of the money that you would have spent on your car, invest it in the stock market or some type of asset that produces a positive net return, you can maximize your dollar bills to make more money. Please like and subscribe again. Let's do this together. Let's do this $1 at a time, and have a profitable day.